So today I'll explore another great tool for Spring developer, that is Spring Tool Suite. And let's download and install and try that tool for the first time. I have been using IntelliJ throughout my career, never tried Spring Tool Suite. I have opened a URL which is spring.io/tools. So here under this page you will see several options for Spring development. First one is with Visual Studio Code. The second one is Spring Tool Suite, which is based on Eclipse. So I'll download and install it on my Windows computer. I'm downloading this Windows version. Actually, it has support for Linux, macOS, and Windows. So downloading the Windows file here, as I can see, it is actually a jar file, which is interesting because it is showing that self-extracting. So whenever you try to open this jar, it will automatically extract. Let's wait for the download to complete. So now the download is complete. It is actually 649 megabyte in size. Here, this is the jar file. This is the Spring Tool Suite I have downloaded to try. So first of all, let's open it and see what happens. Okay, as I can see here, it is extracting. As the name suggests, it is a self-extracting file. So after the operation is complete, we'll have a folder containing the portable Spring Tool Suite, as of my understanding so far. So let's see what it is. Yeah, extraction is done here inside this. Here I have a executable file. This is actually not an installer. This folder is a portable version of Spring Tool Suite. So since this is a portable software, I should copy this folder to a secure place and then create a shortcut and put that on my desktop. That is, you know how to do. So let's just try this tool for the first time. So it is taking some time as it is opening for the first time. First of all, just like Eclipse, it is asking me to select a directory for workspace. You know, IntelliJ doesn't ask for anything like this, but I think it is good that a dedicated folder, a dedicated place for the repositories. So I'm launching the IDE. So let's see how it looks. This is the landing page of Spring Tool Suite. So it pretty much looks like Eclipse, but I have some option like create new Spring starter project. I've never seen that in Eclipse. So as we can see, this tool is based on Eclipse but dedicated for Spring development. Okay, so I can create a new Spring starter project from here, from file new Spring starter project, or just click on Spring starter project. Okay, so let's create a new Spring starter project. Let's create a project called test sts. Okay, default location, I want to make it a maven project. Jar com dot test sts, artifact is test sts, package name is com dot test sts dot tutorial. So this is the name of my package, this is the description, this is the version which I can change later, this is the artifact group name. So let's click on next, and here I can select the dependency I need for my application. So for now, let's just create a blank project. Let's just add Spring Web. Okay, so I'm adding Spring Web and clicking on finish, and a new project just started. It is pretty much like Eclipse. So the folder structure is not like IntelliJ. As we can see in IntelliJ, folder structure is like this when you first time create a project. So I have to open the application's main file which is this one, test sts application, under the project tutorial com.test sts.tutorial. So this is my application's starting point. Let's run my application Spring Boot app. It asking to exclude from firewall. Clicking on allow for the first time. Oh my god, the port 8080 is already in use. And this is how it looks. I think it compared to IntelliJ, which is not free. The premium version, the ultimate version, is paid. And if I run a project on IntelliJ, it looks like this. Sorry, once again. Let's just change the port to 8888. Okay, so running the project from IntelliJ, and it looks like this, but on Spring Tool Suite, it looks like this. But since this is a free option, so you should definitely check it out if you are looking for a free solution. I think it will be better from IntelliJ Community Edition, but it will not be better from IntelliJ Ultimate, but you can get the job done with this tool. And it is officially recommended by Spring, so you will get the support from them. Okay, so this is how Spring Tool Suite looks like. I'm very interested in your experience and your opinion on this tool. Feel free to comment down in the comment section below. I'll be happy to reply or check out your comments. Thank you so much for watching.